Maybe sometime. Hi, it's Todd from Todd's Workshop and Todd Cutler here, and I'm back with the Catapulta again, and this is the second part of a two-part series. And now we're right at the point where we're going to put the tension up. We're going to put the power up. Because in the last film that I did, I managed to get to, I think it was 122 kilos at 45 centimetres, 18 inches. So that's about 250 pounds at 18 inches. Now that's powerful, but it's not super powerful. I mean, it's going to drive an arrow a long way, but it's not going to drive it the 660 yards the Romans said these things could do. Whether I ever get there, I doubt. But I want to get 350, 400 yards. That would be lovely. That's my aim with this machine. And I've built it well enough and constructed it accurately enough, I should be able to achieve that. But that's for another film. But this one now, we're going to start putting the power up. And I have to do exactly what they did, which is I need to find a way of really getting some serious torque on the spanner that does this. The spanner is 1.8 metres, 6 foot long. I need to resist it in a frame. You could see from the last film, I wasn't able to hold it. I couldn't get somebody to hold it well enough for me to tension this up. So it's really a simple thing. I've got a steel frame here that I made years ago, and I just put the clamps on it, and now I can get my spanner on it and really crank it up. I'm going to start tensioning it up now, but you're going to see something interesting happening. So I'm going to crank that in just a little bit at the moment. So first of all, the whole frame's moving, which is really annoying. I made this 10 years ago. I must have been more stupid then than I am now. I'm going to clamp some crossbars on it. But the other thing is just watch the movement of that arm and that arm. It's kind of obvious, but what I'm doing is I'm increasing the power on this side. So it's pushing the arm around more and turning that one. What that means is that you have to balance the system. You turn that one a little bit, you turn that bit. Ideally, of course, they're both going to be exactly the same. Realistically, in a handmade object, they're not. So you turn that one until the string is straight, turn that one a bit more, and just keep going until you've tightened them a bit, straighten it. Then you flip the whole thing over and you have to do the bottom bundles as well. So it's all a bit of a process, this. None of it is very quick. I've got my two crossbars in now, and I can finally start winding up the power on this thing, really giving it some effort. That's Basil, by the way. We thought she was a boy. Anyway, that's another story. I'm looking for the balance on this. Now, I felt that was getting relatively tight, so I'm just going to back this one off a little bit, the first one, because, of course, I have to tighten the bottom ones as well. What I'm going to do next is to flip this over and tension the other side so that we can try and get the top and the bottom of these coils reasonably balanced. But before I do that, I mentioned before that it's really important that these things are tight. Now, the reason that you want them to be tight is if you just put twist after twist after twist, when you pull the arms back, the outsides of the bundles, i.e. some of the ropes, are doing work, but the inside are not really under much tension at all. So basically, you get a very lazy machine. So what you want to do to get an efficient machine, and the Romans were just fabulous at this, is that you pre-tension these things. You absolutely pull them tight, and you pull it until a Roman legionary can pluck it and hear a particular note. He clips it off, he clamps it, we don't know how they did that, and then he winds it on to the next one, pulls it tight until he gets a particular note. That tightness is critical, absolutely critical. And we don't know how they did it, so I had to invent a device for doing it. So I'll show you that. And this is the bar, the lever, that I used to tension the chords on this. So that goes on the bottom there. You tie off your cord on the first loop on the bar. You bring it up, pass it over this peg, and then just lash it on these cleats here. Makes the job a little bit quicker. But then you push it forward, and the relationship of these components stretches the cord, stretches it as much as this wants to stretch. And then you clamp it off. Like I said, we don't know how they did it. I did it with a modified G-clamp. You clamp it to keep that tension on. And then take all that off, turn this up the other way, thread the cord back through, go again. It took two of us a day to do this. Very laborious process. So our headstock is now in the other way up. So I'm doing what were the bottom bundles. Process is exactly the same. Let's do that one first. Now this, I'm guessing, is going to be harder. Okay. So, what I'm going to do now, twist this bundle, and I'm going to stop when the bowstring is about parallel. Oh my goodness me. No, I'm not. I've lost courage. I'm going to undo that first one a little bit. I'm sorry, I'm just not brave enough to try and shoot that yet. I'm not familiar enough with it. The string's parallel. Everything's good. I've put it up, obviously, a lot of power. Now I'm just going to drop some pins into these holes. But let's just get a feel for what I'm dealing with now. It's times like this where I really wonder why I'm doing this. Look at this. That is everything. I don't know what that is, but I can span basically a 200-pound crossbow by hand. So whatever that is getting somewhere close to that. 4 inches, 10 centimetres. Whew. Well, that's going to do something. So we just need to get the headstock back on and then we'll weigh it and see what we got. The last time I tensioned this thing up, the whole thing was assembled. I tried to give it as much as I could while it was here in this position. Couldn't do it. Managed to get 122 kilos at 45 centimetres, so about 250, 260 pounds at 18 inches. Let's see what we got now. That may be some time. Right, I can tell you right now, my courage will be through the floor on this one. 0 kilos. So that's our first mark there, same as it was before. Now, I don't know if you can see from there, but that's our 10 inch and our 18 inch. So our 25 centimetres, our 45 centimetres. I don't think I'm even going to get there. I've been criticised about my safety in a couple of films I've recently done. There was one about a trebuchet with multiple bolts, another about a dagger that I was pushing through armour. Now, the thing is, I have 25 years in special effects before all of this, and I have a danger radar that is really pretty good. And you mustn't forget that TV, film, special effects, you can make things look dangerous and they're not. It's not my intention, but you might have a different view of what it feels like. Those films, I actually felt safe. This one, this actually disturbs me. My only safety here is just being very careful and very cautious. Interesting. 6 inches, 15 centimetres, that is 118 kilos, which is what? 118, 240, 250, 260 pounds. I'm not going to go very much more today. Well, maybe I will, I don't know. Let's see how it feels. Does it make horrible noises? So, 153 kilos, 320 pounds. So this is interesting because it begins to tell me a bit what kind of weight we're dealing with. It's okay, it's significant. It's okay. I built crossbows with a lot more. Okay, I'm just listening. Okay, we're not quite 18 inches. Right, 210 kilos. That, over that draw length, is a lot. You know what? I'm going to stop there. So we're on about 16 inches. Okay, but also I've got more power left in that winch. I can give this more. But you know what? Today, I'm nervous. We're going to shoot this thing, see what it does. Let's load her up and let's go. Well, I'm back and we have already got a problem. I haven't even begun to shoot it, but I just noticed while I was checking over the machine, this cord bundle here has slipped off the little ledge where it's supposed to stay. So that means, well, good news, I'm going to shoot it. I can shoot it once, twice, I'm sure it'll be fine. Fingers crossed. But it does mean I have to dismantle this machine again. These whole bundles aren't going to come out, but that's another film, that's the next film. That's what that'll be, is stripping these arms out and changing them and getting it back together. Which is interesting, because I'll show you a bit of kit you haven't seen. So here, you can see the left-hand arm. The cords are all where they're meant to be, tucked away behind that wedge. On the right-hand arm, you can see now that a few of these chords have started to slide up the wedge. This whole arm has moved into the machine, and that is no good at all. I'm going to have a couple of shots now with this. I think it's safe enough to do that. They're not going to be super powerful ones, but we're going to get an idea. But what I really want to know is what kind of speed we're going to get out of this. Because at the moment, I'm going to take the short, go for short distances. But if I can get over about 150, 160 feet per second, something like that, I will be very excited about what we're going to get. Because I do know that 160 feet per second is going to give you around about 200, 220 metres, something like that. Sorry about all the mixed numbers, but if you're into bows, you'll probably work it out. First problem, of course, is this string is slightly too far forward now because the arm's moved and I can't get my teeth in. So the crowbar comes back out again. Is that going to do it? Yes! Bet the Romans didn't do that. What do we got there? Well, that feels like it's going to do something. 250 gram bolt. In honesty, only a teensy bit scared. Right, don't want to take my chrono out either. And loose! Well, disappointingly, the chrono didn't register. That means one of two things. It either wasn't over 145 feet per second, or the chrono just didn't pick it up. Because, of course, that's really meant for going on the front of guns and things. Anyway, let's go again. We'll see. I've got to get a feel for this machine. I've got to learn it. And anything that you learn, you don't want to learn it when it's in its most dangerous state. You want to learn it when it's not so dangerous. Loose. That sounded and felt more powerful. And, very good news, 166 feet per second. So I know that those numbers are going to be up in the 230, 240 meter range now. Bit more than the 150, 160 I originally said. But what that really means is I know I can go up from here. That had plenty of drawback yet before we even hit the 18 inch mark, the 45 centimeters. And it's got more power that I could put in when I actually use the levers. 166 feet per second, we're gonna leave that one behind. And that was on a 250 gram bolt. And for those of you who want the numbers, 166 feet per second, I've just done a calculation, 55 meters a second, and that is delivering 640 joules. That's a whopper. And we're going up from there. So this is, I'll put money on it, we can get over 1,000 joules with this bow, which is extraordinary for a arrow-type weapon. I'll see you again another time. But this has excited me because it felt safe. It didn't have the safe, obviously not totally safe, depends which end you're on. But it didn't have that fear that when I was looking at the numbers that was kind of in my heart, it felt good. As a final sign off, I'd just like to make a correction. I originally called this a catapulta, and in fact it is. And I was adamant that it is not a ballista. Well, at the time that this machine was designed, around about the birth of Christ, it was a catapulta. But by the time we get to the 4th century AD, they were referring to bolt throwing machines like this as ballista. And then, of course, we get into the medieval times, and ballisteri is Italian for crossbowmen, and a catapulta is something that shoots rocks. And so everything is thoroughly reversed. But at the time I did this, catapulta. But anyway, I think the point being is, let's not get too precious about whether it's a ballista or a catapulta. Kind of call it either, really, and it works. We all know what we're talking about. See ya.